Get ready to match the stars. Joey Bishop, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Wright, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Randall.
Isn't that awesome? Thank you very much. Sorry to delay you there. I was reading a fascinating book. Don't tell me how it ends.
The butler did it.
No, it's All the President's Men.
Oh, really?
Don't know how it ends, but I'm going to finish it later there.
Yeah, well.
How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm all right. Are
you all dressed
right?
Up again? Yes, you got a double-breasted vest.
That's right. I have a double-breasted vest.
Wow. You don't hardly see those anymore.
No, you don't. They're coming back, Mary.
Oh,
watch this, sweet lady. Saturday nights at 8:30 on CBS.
Doc.
She's very funny. It's called Doc. And you'll see she wears a white uniform, but you'll recognize her. It's the same.
I'm heavily veiled, however.
That's right. Is there anything else anyone has to plug or say? Yes, what?
Yeah.
July the 12th.
What's July 12th?
Nothing. I don't want to say like a dummy, so I throw it July the 12th.
Remember, Joyce is
nice
July 12th.
I like July 12th.
Now, Larry Guthrie and Gloria Henley, welcome to you.
Thank you.
Now, this fella. You got a nice wardrobe. You know that. He's a pretty snappy dresser, isn't he, John?
Yeah.
Neat looking kid there.
Thank you.
Yeah, he's a current champ. That's right. Larry Guthrie here. He's got $1,800, and he does indeed bear a slight resemblance to Alan Ludden. But doesn't he? Yes.
Wish I had his name.
Hello there. How are you? Anyway, when we left last time, the score was 5-4. We had a very lively first round because we've got two good game players here. Gloria has 5. Are you ready to carry on, Gloria?
Oh, yes.
Come with me and we'll carry on. Have I? No. We're going to do a little message for America now, and then we will pick up with you two. Come right back. Here we go. Bing. Round 2 coming up. Gloria, it's up to you, A or B?
B.
B it is. Is that what you had last time, Gloria?
Right.
It is. It was lucky for her last time. Only one person plays.
Oh,
Joey.
Wow.
I don't want to say you're a dummy, Joey, but you're the only one. She captured everybody else in the first round. Yeah. Ready? Joey?
I just want to say one thing.
What's that?
It's not a good show, but what a cast.
Listen.
What?
Arnold the Anteater said, I hate King Kong. Every time he comes around, he picks me up and uses me to clean his blank. You don't like that question? It's the only one we got, Joey. Arnold the Anteater said, I hate King Kong. Every time he comes around, he picks me up and uses me to clean his blank.
Right.
Big Brother is watching.
Very nice, Don.
Not very good, but nice. Hello, Gloria.
Hi.
You ready? You know who King Kong is?
Yeah.
Arnold the Anteater said, I hate King Kong. Every time he comes around, he picks me up and uses me to clean his...
Fur.
Fur. Now, wait a minute. That ain't bad. Wait till you hear his.
What did she say?
She said, fur.
No kidding.
Yeah. The rules say you gotta show
I said cage.
Cage, yeah, that's what he said. He said cage. Yes.
Cage.
What about... What did you have in mind for that one over there?
I wouldn't.
Teeth. That would have been good. Yes, I suppose so. All right. Now, Larry, it's up to you.
Well.
One to tie and two to win.
Wow.
All right.
We'll try it.
Two people play.
Just frickin' frack.
Oh, frickin' frack. Just the two of you. Ready now? All right. Here we go.
What are we going to play?
Oh, no. This game.
Oh.
Match game 76. Sir. Don't be too disappointed now. I'll read
In
it.
In honor of Mary, why don't we play doctor?
No, I did that when I was 10 years
old.
Not unless I'm in it. Not unless you're in it. You can be in it there.
Oh, okay.
Martha Washington said, my husband George was a first minute man.
Yeah.
It only... Well, that's tacky already.
No, wait a minute.
Before you go any further.
You're going to answer? No, wait, I haven't finished the question.
Yeah, yeah. I guarantee I'm going to
It only took him a minute to blink.
There you are.
Come on now. Here we go, here we go. Larry, are you ready? Have you thought about this? I'm going to read it again anyway, Larry, whether you like it or not.
Thank you.
Martha Washington said,
"My husband George was the first Minuteman. It only took him a minute to blank."
Shave.
Shave?
Oh, you don't.
What was your first choice?
I'd rather not.
Oh. Okay.
Shave.
He said shave. Larry's looking for a shave. What do you give?
Come to the wrong place. I said make love.
Only give him a minute to make love. Larry, had you thought of that? Did that cross your mind?
Oh, yeah.
you know, he said
but it's
that.
It's been a while.
Oh, it takes a while. I see. Didn't get warmed up. All right, now you must match what's her name here in order to achieve a tie and stay in the game.
What was yours again?
He said make love.
Oh, no, he said make love.
Oh, you said
that's
make love.
That's where you
love.
Heard
no.
it, yeah.
Larry's, well, it was a shave.
Shave.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
He's looking for a shave. Unlikely. But such a weirdo, you never tell. So.
I'm sorry, I said to go to sleep after.
Go to sleep? Oh, really? All right, Lindsay, come on down, Larry. Yeah. You got time, Larry. Get around here for a minute or so. Well, pal, you're going to leave here with a total of $1,800. Larry Guthrie. What a ball.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, this is the first game Gloria Henley has won, and we'll take her right to it. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, well, you know how this big money super match goes. You can win over $5,000 here. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Smokey blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, but you got to match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, and the bottom gets you $100. Now, Gloria, you can get a little help here from some of the ding-a-lings.
Brett, how about Smokey the Bear?
Smokey the Bear. Smokey the Bear.
Mary.
Mary, have you got one?
Smokey Mountains.
Smokey Mountains.
Yes, aren't there Smokey Mountains?
Sure. Okay, yes,
Smokey.
No, that's a different one, Brett.
Oh. Charles.
Smokey Joe.
Smokey Joe.
In Encino, for those drinks, a lovely after-hours club, Smokey Joe.
Sexiest
Smokey Joe. Smokey Joe. Now, what the hell is that, Charles?
I don't know, but it sounds good. Smokey Joe.
All right, so those are three, Gloria. Smokey Joe, Smokey Mountains, and Smokey the Bear.
Smokey the Bear.
All right. No other ideas in your head?
Smokey Robinson.
Smokey Robinson. But that's your second choice?
Yes.
Smokey the Bear is your first choice. Let's find out if that little rascal is up there under the $100 response. Smokey Joe. Will some kind person please tell me?
Happy hour is from 5 to 8. Ask the Larry. It's fabulous.
Come on, there's no Smokey Joe.
Plenty of parking.
You never heard of
never
it.
Heard.
Anybody here ever hear of Smokey
Joe? Well, obviously
Joe?
Somebody has.
Yeah, did you ever hear of it?
Joe.
Yeah, the weirdo with the beard and glasses. Did you ever hear of it?
That's Smokey Joe.
Yeah, oh, that is Smokey Joe. Oh, I'm sorry.
Hi, Joe.
All right, let's find out if Smokey the Bear is... What's that? Who it is?
I heard of it.
Joey, who?
Thank you.
I heard of it three times from him.
Oh, I see. Oh, dear. Let's find out if Smokey the Bear is under the $250 response. Smokey Robinson.
Smokey Robinson.
That was your second choice.
He got me.
All right. Smokey the Bear. Let's find out if he's under the $500 number. Slide it, Earl.
Yeah!
Congratulations, my dear. You now have a total of $600. And before we go on and see how you're going to do with the rest of the big money super match here, we're going to stop and do a little business with America. Is that okay with you? Okay with you. Come back. Here we go. Gloria, you've won the $500. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. But to collect, you got to match one celebrity exactly. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
All right, Richard.
Smokey Joe's are here.
Yeah. I've got two versions. Smokey Joe was a character in Tom Sawyer, the book Tom Sawyer.
Really? Also, Minnie the Moocher.
And also a character in the song Minnie the Moocher, Cab Calloway's famous song.
Yeah, his theme song.
Really?
Yes.
But I remember the song. All right. Oh, yeah, she was a hoochie-coochie. You ready?
Yeah.
You got a little ESP going between you and Richard? Think Richard Dawson. Are you thinking that? Okay,
yeah.
Here we go. My friend blank. My friend blank. Now, Gloria Henley, an answer from you which will match Richard Dawson's. What do you say to that? My friend.
I can't think of it.
Can you spell it?
Joey.
What were you trying to think of?
It's on the tip of my tongue. I can't remember.
Oh, well, maybe Richard will help refresh your memory here. Turn around and look at Richard here.
There's a show when I first came to this country.
On television.
Called My Friend Irma.
My Friend Irma. It was a very popular show. Do you remember that one?
No.
Oh, you don't?
Were you thinking of Flicka?
My Friend Flicka.
Flicka.
Is that what you're trying to think of?
That was a show. And I came.
Well, there are two. My Friend Flicka and My Friend Irma.
Either one. Certainly not My Friend Joe.
No. But he's a friendly fellow. Now, Gloria, you've got a total of $600. And you're going to meet another player, so let's welcome Linda Nellens over here. Thank you for asking. Please tell us where you're from and all that sort of thing.
Well, I'm from Indiana originally.
Yeah.
And I've been out here almost 7 years, and I tend bar.
You tend bar?
Yeah, I'm bartender.
Is that why your skin is so pale and smooth?
Oh,
because you never see
the
light of day or the sunshine. Yes.
Not until 6. I get the moonshine.
Is that interesting work?
Oh, I love it, yeah.
Yeah.
Meet all kinds of people.
You do. Yeah, I guess you do. You ever see Brett? Yeah. You ever see My Friend Brett?
Not yet, but maybe I will later.
She makes them all sooner or later. She gets around every one of them.
Right.
Now, Linda, good luck to you. You may have A or B.
I'll take B, please.
B it is? Okay. B is what she wants. B is what she gets.
Okay.
Count Dracula said, I am running for president of Transylvania.
Ooh.
Elect me, and I promise you a blank in every pot.
Campaign promise. I'm running for president of Transylvania. Elect me, and I promise you a blank in every pot. That is what Dracula said.
I promise you a blank in every pot.
All right. Okay. First round questions are tougher. Yes, I have to agree with that.
It's tough to answer.
But they're challenges.
Oh, gosh, otherwise I wouldn't do the show.
That's right. Okay, Linda.
Count Dracula said, I'm running for president of Transylvania. Elect me and I promise you a blank in every pot.
How about a bat?
A bat. Promise you a bat in every pot. Okay. I don't know whether that'd be good or not there.
Now, we're going to have a lot of technical problems here.
Why?
Okay, because a bat was, in essence, a vampire who became a bat.
A vampire bat.
So I took no chances and I wrote vampire bat. Now,
no argument there. That's a match.
Oh, yeah.
We don't fight here in the show. Well, once in a while.
He's so unused to being right
that
he gets into an argument before. Well, I thought you've heard about cooking with wine.
Yes.
I said you'd find a bucket of blood. It's similar.
Bucket of blood. That's a reasonable answer. Hello, Charles.
I said vampire.
Vampire. Can we have a buzz or a ding?
Sometimes.
Sometimes it takes a little while because that's a tough decision to make.
Followed the dots.
Yes, he did follow the dots. He connected all the dots up that were on the card Which were placed there by Count Dracula, right?
No, by Goodson and Todman.
Oh, I see. All right. Now, Mary. You ready for this one, Mary?
I hope you'll accept this little token of our love and esteem, not for its intrinsic value, but for the love we hold for you.
I promise you a chicken in every pot.
A human heart.
A human heart in every pot. Okay, that's a good answer. That's what he would say, right, Richard?
He certainly would.
What else would he say?
I want the judges to listen very carefully because, as Joey pointed out, a bat does become a vampire,
right,
and a vampire does become a bat. Is that
right,
correct?
Yes.
Heart.
Well, it was a nice try. Nice try. But
work for Joey.
I don't think. You know, we appreciate your efforts, sir, but we can't go on that way. And
please don't talk about me when I'm gone.
What do you say? All right. Contractors, I'm running for president of Transylvania. Elect me, and I promise you a blank in every pot. And what's her name said bat.
What's your name?
Gloria Henry said bat.
I didn't.
What did you say? No, Vanilla said that.
I said a neck.
A neck? You are a dummy! Hurry right back and see how this game carries on here. With Gloria's first round question. Bye!
I have to go.
Oh, there you are. Now, this is your first round question. Ready for it? Listen carefully now. Tonto. Left the Lone Ranger and opened an Indian restaurant. When the Lone Ranger came to the door, Tonto said, sorry, Kimo Sabe, but to get in here, you need blank. Think about it now. Open an Indian restaurant.
Oh, I got it. I got it. Honey, you're just terrific.
Let me just see if you got it. Go ahead.
Did I give it away? I already have my answer. Let me see. Isn't that sweet?
Now you got a chance. You got to tell the panel the thing.
I don't think I did get it, now that I think about it.
What?
I already have my answer.
Don't we make a lovely couple? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yes.
Tonto left the Lone Ranger and opened an Indian restaurant. When the Lone Ranger came to the door, Tonto said, sorry, Kimo Sabe, but to get in here, you need...
feathers?
You don't think, do you? Pale face. Well, I don't mean that either. Feathers. Tonto left the Lone Ranger.
Can we get the show over before the NAACP shows up?
What do you say?
Well, now here's my thinking, okay?
Right.
Tonto, Indian.
Right.
Restaurant.
Right.
My answer was you can't get in there unless you have a reservation.
That's the answer.
Very good.
That's the answer. Is that what you thought? That's what they thought, too.
That's very good.
The squaw lady's looking for feathers. What are you giving?
I figured at Sardi's you need a reservation. At Backstage you need a reservation. I figured to get into an Indian restaurant you needed a squaw. Well, not necessarily, I guess.
No. That's Charles.
How much you bet I got feathers on that card? I'm going to put my gold watch. What do you want to put up?
You going to put up your gold watch?
What?
I have nothing to offer here except an old chicken. What? Feather! Oh, I'm done.
Upside down, Feather.
Okay, Mary. Sorry, Kimo Sabe, but to get in here, you need feathers, according to her.
Well, what? Did you ever try to get out of an Indian restaurant without paying? You need wampum.
Wampum. Not a good one. That's good. Sorry, Kimo Sabe, but to get in here, you need...
silver.
Silver,
Very good.
Play on words there. Very good. What do they say?
Well, the thing is I don't know where this expression came from, but I thought an Indian may have made it up.
What?
Wooden nickels.
Ugh. You're getting dumber every minute. Okay, so at the end of round one, 2-1 is the score in favor of Linda. Here's a message for you.
Watson, don't take any good.
You're hoofing muffins.
Here we are, friends. That's the end. Just have a quick goodbye.
A quick goodbye.
Okay. Bye-bye. A quick goodbye. 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 Goodbye.